Hi guys, and welcome to another Divi theme video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, today we're going to build this nice little Twitter timeline, and it's pulling it directly from my Twitter feed here. Today we're using the Divi Plus plugin. It's a premium plugin. I'll put the link below the builder, and it adds about 40 or so extra modules, and there's some awesome addition here, and it also adds some extensions as well. So let's get started. This is really easy to do. I'm going to enable my Visual Builder. There we go. And you will need the Divi Plus plugin enabled to do this today. So let's get rid of this and we'll start from scratch. I'm going to hit the little button to add a new module here. All these light gray ones with the blue icon are included with the Divi theme, and just about enough for any site there. All these ones with the DP in front of them are the ones you get with the Divi Plus plugin. There's plenty of them, and there's some fantastic additions here. I'm looking for the Twitter timeline right here. So I'm going to left click on it. And there it is. What you want to remember when you put in your Twitter username is just to get rid of the hashtag in front. You don't take away the hashtag, it won't work. And there we go. As you can see, it's put a little feed in there from my timeline. You can set the tweet limit to how many you want to show here. Let's set mine to about 5. You can use the slider, or you can type in a value, and you can increment with the little arrows on the side there. If you don't want it tracked, you can turn this to off. If you do, just turn it on. And basically what this is going to do, it's not going to be used for purposes that include personal suggestions and Google ads and stuff like that. It's not going to track it. So I'm going to leave mine to off. Display wise, you can choose to show replies if you want to. You can choose the light or the dark theme. There's the light, obviously. Dark, obviously. Now, if you've got a dark background, or you want to put a dark background into your actual module here itself, leave it on the dark version. I'll show you why, how in just a second. You can choose to show no header. That tweets has gone now. No footer. No borders. There's a little border right between the tweets there. And no background, if you're going to put your own background in, or you just want to leave it as it is. Now we've got the dark version, so the writing's kind of light there. So we can put our own background in there in a moment. We can also make these a little bit bigger. Let's make them 450. And the actual frame height itself, you can make bigger or smaller. I'm going to leave mine on the default there. Now here's the background. If you wanted to put a background color in, if you've got a dark background, leave it on the dark theme. If you've got a light background, leave it on the light theme, obviously. I'm going to leave mine just as it is, so I'll put that back to transparent. And in display, I'm going to switch this back to light so the writing's dark. There we go, that works for me. Fantastic. So that's pretty much all there is to it. If we go to design, you can align it within your column, middle, right, or left. Fallback text in case your images don't load. You can choose your text. Divi by default has got a ridiculous amount of fonts. There are literally hundreds and hundreds. And if you just hover over one, it'll show you an example of what that text is actually going to look like there. But I'll leave mine on the default there. You can give it a box shadow. That's going to give the whole module a box shadow, which doesn't really work for me, but it may work for you. You can give it some borders if you want. Sizing wise, you can choose a max width and max height. Again, I'm going to leave mine just as it is because we've chose to show 5 tweets there, and that'll work fine for me. Spacing, transform, animation, don't need to change anything at all there. So we're pretty happy with that. So let's just save this and see what we've got. Save the draft. Exit the Visual Builder when you're ready. And there we have it. We've got a nice live Twitter feed going on there with 5 posts. And that'll update in real time. And your newest one will appear at the top and it'll push them down incrementally. And that's a nice feature to have on your site. Like I say, we're using the Divi Plus for this today. You'll find the link below the video if anybody wants to check it out. So I hope you've enjoyed this today and found it useful. If you have, please give it a thumbs up, comment, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and WebDesignAndTechTips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.